Okay, so today I'm just gonna talk a little bit about what's been going on. There was a little bit of a market drop on Monday that was kind of dramatic. It was from the hearsay on the grapevine that it was $300 billion in China with a real estate firm, and it just made the They apparently didn't have the money or something, and they so it created like a massive drop across the board. Like for everybody, all the companies. So that just goes to show that there is not a buffer, that there is total global cohesion going on, with the financial market. If you have global cohesion going on with the financial market, we're all linked, we're all linked together. There's no separation there. When one company in China has that ability to just go, yeah, with the big swipe of the paw to the whole US, to everything, That's pretty damning. It's damning that there is not a security in place to make that stop. It's nearly impossible now because the way the whole economy has been structured and how it's all been, yes, of course, we'll take your money over there in China and we'll do loans with you in China if they're cheaper. Or Japan or wherever, all of this is start going on, all of this international trade, we end up, all it needs is the carpet pulled out in one of those countries, and the whole economy takes a clunk. I mean, that's absurd. That's absolutely absurd, but that's the fashion, and that's the way it's been set up. And I've been racking my mind going, okay, how to fix, how to fix, how to fix. Well, I already made that voucher idea so everybody did have a house and we weren't bevied into the mortgage structure for that first house. So we wouldn't be what is the term, kowtowed out to China or kowtowed out to India or wherever, I mean, it just goes to show, it can be even corruption that goes on over there. And we end up at a complete loss. The economy goes just takes a kerplunk. I mean, that was just outstanding. So, anyway. Yeah, you have to make some kind of fail safe, and the fail safe is to restructure the system and not be, especially since it was a real estate loan mogul situation, losing all of the cash. Well, in that, we can't be, chained to it. That's all. You have to release yourself from the chains of that system. You can't let Russia all of a sudden just drop its turkeys, and then all of a sudden we fall. You can't let China drop its whatever pennies and we fall. You have to have a secure. And interestingly enough, when all of this has been going on, I found out that I'm 37% Scottish, and I'm thrilled. And yes, that's the Croft system. Very interesting, isn't it? It's the Croft system where you have your house, and you didn't pay a mortgage on it ever. It was perhaps if there was something earned out of the house or out of the place of that house. That went into the system, if you raised turnips, it went into back into the system. But yeah, Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, it was one of those days that it was just like, so you're looking at the cause of a bear, or you're looking at the cause of a crash, and now apparently it's just never going to be here, is it? It's not even going to be in the US, I don't believe. I believe it's now going to be a global crash from somewhere else. And we have no say in the matter. Just not, nothing. It's just like, oh, well, too bad for you that you live in that country. Too bad, because now you're all gonna get swiped out. Your economy is gonna get swiped out. Just a jitterbug. It bounced back happily, but it was a jitterbug, and it was allowed to be a jitterbug event. They had a lot of play and a lot of authority. That should just piss everybody off. That should just say, hey, we don't want that kind of a financial market. We want a market that is stable, that is not just like based upon one company in China or a bank. I think it was Zach's, and he said go, Zach's newsletter, he mentioned going back to some layman's in 2008. He was trying to compare it to that. And I don't even know if it's been repaired. The point is what it did, what it did. 300 billion is a lot of money. And that's money in China, though, but it affected us here. That's all. Just seems pretty easy to be malicious. Doesn't feel like a safe system. It doesn't feel like a system you can trust. It just feels like it's up for that to happen again. History repeat. Oh, that was cool. Well, so while that's going on, there's people out there shorting the market, getting gobs of money off their shorts, off the short gain, the fall, So when that's going on, who's watching that? And you can't say that it wasn't a corrupt event. You can't even, there's no trace on that. Could very well have been a corrupt event. And then somebody's saying, over there in India, now you pick up the pieces, pick up the pieces of the short. Because I'm dumping this company, 300 billion, and it's all falling. So you pick up the pieces. And so all of that can be going on behind the little USA's back. It's not even controllable. It's just like, you're looking at the market and going, well, I just take it or leave it, because it can't be trusted. It really cannot be trusted. And that type of event shows it. That type of event proves it can't be trusted. They're just astounding. Anyway, so back to genealogy. I'm going to push the market aside when we talk genealogy. I contacted the ancestry.com because there's been some discrepancy in my line, and I've been looking at it and looking at relatives, and I'm going, how come they have such different disparity in the blood? Like that one is saying more French or more Spanish, and how come I'm over here saying, more Scottish? Well, what happens? What happens? They're trying to tell me is the you can have your parents there, and you think it's 50-50, but it's not necessarily 50-50. Apparently, the blood that you receive, one ends up being stronger in your system than another. And so I'm really confused because I really thought it was 50-50. So when you have one stronger than the other, that will change your DNA makeup completely. So you can be registering as more Indian, more Native Indian, or you can be registering as more Scot. So it was very, and I asked, I said, well, what about alcohol? You know, if you take these tests and you have alcohol in your system or a big bunch of drugs or something. And he said, no, that does not affect the DNA. And then what about cancer? If you have cancer, no, that does not affect the DNA. And I really thought it did. I thought those things would affect the DNA, you know, change your molecules a bit. But no, he was saying not, that it really is, you are given a little bit more of stronger strength bloodline, like say from your mother versus your father, or from your father versus your mother. It's very, very interesting to me. So you can have a brother or a brother that is completely different. I mean, there'll be a few things and you'll still be brother and it'll still say that you're the same percentage, but that he might lean more towards the mother or lean more towards the father. So I learned incredible about that, because I thought for sure that was a 50-50. It's not. So now I'm this 37% Scot. So now I have to do what? I have to join some Scottish club somewhere. And say put a Mick in front of everything. Anyway, I did my dance things. I don't know if I'm going to do too many more of those. It's getting, you know, what? I am 56 this month, so I can dance. I can probably dance until I'm 100, but I don't know. Sometimes I don't feel so wanted. You know, I'm a little fatter than normal and whatever, you know. And I did notice like Cutesy Sarah Mearns from New York City Ballet. She's a little larger than the others. And she cracks me up, you know, that the fact that she's still ballerina and she's still out there. And I think that's great. I hope they don't, you know, put the X on her and say, no, you're too heavy. But I mean, I you know, in a way that's for her to decide, because if she doesn't feel like she can jump enough anymore, or you know, do tricks or even partner, you know, if she can't do lifts and that type of thing, it gets in the way, you know. So yeah, anyway, she did give me a little bit of silliness, and so there I am with my pink tights, and I'm feeling like, oh, you're such an idiot. Anyway, so that was it. That was it. That's all I have to say today. I just wanted to revisit and talk, you know. And major gardening is going on. It is the time to start planting. I know I've been dancing with my thumbs out a lot. It's time to start planting the greens. Get your lettuce, your turnips, your kale, your cabbage, your broccoli, I think also, spinach, all of these things. It's time to get them out there in the soil. Radish. What else? Did I forget something? I'm not sure if it's celery season also. You can try it. And already, and clover, I put clover out, clover seeds, and they bounced up in like in one day, overnight. So it's really clover season. So if you have any clover, that's great to revitalize your soil. So don't forget that. And that's it. That's it. And I don't have an answer, like I said, except make sure our houses are set up in a way that no other country or no other company from another country can actually take them away from us, you know what I mean? Because that's what's going on when you have that type of an economic controller happen. That's just unreal. That's like a world dominance play. Anyway.